Hey, what's up, Beat Hackers? In this week's video, I wanted to teach you about a concept of taking a track and mixing it with another version of that track. So sometimes you can take like a really old song that's been remixed and merge the two, or take a song that's been remixed and merge those two. I'm kind of waffling now, but let's just get straight into the video and I'm gonna show you exactly what I'm talking about. Okay guys, so let's just get straight into this. So, if I was to take a song called Something's Got a Hold of Me and play the first bit, there's a high chance you're gonna recognize this track.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah.
Okay, it's a song called Something's Got a Hold of Me by Etta James, but you guys will know it because it's been remixed so many times. Avicii, Flo Rida, Skrillex did a remix of the Avicii track. And the thing is, right, if you can find songs like this, you can really kind of tease your audience. So, I've got four different tracks here that all use this sample or this track in some way. I'm just gonna kind of run you through all the different ways you could potentially mix these different tracks. So, first things first, if I was to play Something That's Got a Hold of Me, and I was gonna mix it straight into the actual Avicii track, okay? Well, I kinda wanna find that point, and I'm just gonna literally go searching for that moment I want the Avicii track to come in. So if I kinda just went forward in this track, let me just bring this down. So, let's kind of have a listen to it around here.
I believe, I really do believe that something's got a hold on me.
Okay. So at this point here, where it kind of gets into the guts of the song, the main part of the song, this point right here is probably where I want the Avicii track to kind of kick in. So now I'll go searching for the point of the Avicii track that I would want to come in at that point. So let's go and see if we can find it. So... okay, so we now know that we want those two points to line up. But I can't just come in at this point like just by going... you potentially could, perhaps, but there's a little moment before this where it kind of builds up to that point. Okay, so I'm probably, because I'm going from one song that's 74 up to a song that's 126, I'm probably going to kind of use a bit of this kind of sound to kind of go into it, okay? The other thing you can really begin to do is use the filter as well to really bring it in so it sounds like it's coming in from nowhere like this. So, that's the concept. I know where the two points need to align, so it would most likely sound a little bit like this. And you can imagine how cool this would be if you were just starting off a DJ set and the first thing your audience heard was just this.
Sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. Yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no. Yeah. I just want to tell you right now that ooh, I believe, I really do believe that.
Okay, as you saw, it wasn't perfect, but there was something epic about it. How cool is it? They're like, you've just come on the stage, the audience are expecting something, you come in with that old song, and then you throw Avicii at them. Makes the hairs on the back of your neck stand on end, and it's cool. It doesn't have to be perfect. It's just the idea, it's the concept that you're throwing these two tracks together. You could even throw a couple effects on it if you wanted to spruce it up, like you could throw like a flanger on it or something. Let's have a quick listen.
I get a good feeling, yeah. Yeah.
If you wanted to spruce it up, you could do something like that. But it was literally just knowing where those two points were, bringing it in, filtering it in, hey presto, you got it. Cool, so now let's move on to the next. So let's just say we had Levels playing and we wanted to bring in Flo Rida. Obviously you guys all know this track, sounds a bit like this.
Yes, I can. Doubt better leave. I'm running with this plan. Pull me, grab me, grab me.
But we know there's a point of this song where it plays that same hook.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling.
Okay, So that's the point. I'm probably going to layer it with the Avicii track. So you just got to go and find that part of the Avicii track, which I think is around here somewhere. The two tracks are different speeds, so I'm going to make sure they're both exactly the same speed. Let's bring that up. So one's 128, the other's 128. And I'm literally here just going to bring the volume down of the Flo Rida track, hit play, beat match it, and then as I bring the volume up of the Flo Rida track, I'm just going to take away some of the mids, some of the lows, and just bring away the volume. That's all I'm going to do. And it allows me to just simply merge the two tracks and bring one in and take the other away. Now, because they're going to be singing the exact same, you may have to play around with the jog wheel to make sure it's perfect. So let's give this a quick go. So let's go back about that far. Let's give it a go.
Get a good feeling, yeah. Get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, 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 I get a good feeling, yeah.
Okay, so there you go. That's how I did it. Now, it's so basic. Like, this is the thing, guys. I didn't want this to be some really super complicated thing. I just wanted it to be like an idea and how I would potentially throw these different tracks together. And if you did like a medley like this, where you came in with that, threw in levels, went to Flo Rida, I'm telling you, your audience are hyped at this point. They're gonna be in the mix so much. They won't even know that you're mixing between these tracks if you do this properly. Now, there's another track in here, Skrillex. He did a version of Levels as well. You guys will probably know it. Sounds a little bit like this. Now, this is a really tricky track. I really struggled thinking, like, how would I blend these two? Because they're different BPMs. They're, like, drastically different keys, like 12B and 4A just don't go together. So I couldn't layer it at all. So I was like, how would I do this, okay? So if I was DJing live and I was like, right, how am I going to do this? I just want to go simple. You just want to think, what's the simplest thing I could do? I always like to just look out for the whoosh, okay? So we're going to bring this back. There's a point of the track that just sounds like this. It's just got a whoosh. Cool. We got a whoosh. Now I would go to the Avicii track and I'd find another whoosh. Now, once you've got two whooshes lined up, you're laughing, okay? You just literally wait for the one whoosh to come, you press play on the other whoosh, and you're into it. Don't worry about BPMs, don't worry about the key. Key doesn't matter, because with a whoosh, all it is like white noise, like, there's no tone to it. So if there's no tone, it can't be in or out of key, it's just air, right? Okay, cool, so let's do this. I'm just gonna, I'm gonna keep it at 128. I'm gonna just bring this back a bit. And the other thing, a little tip as well, when there's a whoosh, you can just kind of filter it out. Don't feel like you need to stop it, you can just filter like. So that's what I'm gonna be doing. Let's give it a go. Awesome. And I can tell you this as well, even people who don't really like dubstep, because they're going to know it's the Avicii song, they'll still get down to it even if they don't like dubstep. And it's really fun to actually you'll spot those characters. You'll be like, yeah, no, she doesn't really like this, but she's just kind of in the moment. Cool, sweet, so there we go. That's that, it's a really cool little concept. There's tons of different tracks, and you could probably even just go and Google, like, famous tracks that have sampled old-fashioned songs. Honest to God, it's easy enough to find these things. Just go and do a Google search. Come out with stuff like this. It's really creative, but it's so simplistic as well. None of those transitions are difficult. They're just really simple, basic transitions. Hopefully, you guys have enjoyed this. You've learned something. If nothing else, you can go and download those four songs and just do this exact thing in your next DJ set. People will absolutely love it. And that's pretty much everything. So, if you've liked this video, make sure you leave a comment. Leave as many comments. Leave 5 or 6 comments if you want, because it helps the video rank. Like the video. Share with your friends. If you want to learn more about DJing and you feel like you just kind of can't quite get the basics down, or you want to push your levels a bit further, make sure you go and check out beginnerdjlessons.com, where I'll teach you everything you need to know about DJing in a simple and easy to follow way. If you guys are interested in making your own dance music, I also teach people how to produce their own dance music from scratch. Way simpler than you think. Got some free training going on at edmcoaching.com. Click the link. I'm currently doing some free live kind of training at the moment, so there's a link beneath this video. You can go and check that out as well. And finally, make sure you subscribe to this channel by hitting that button there. Hit the bell notification so you get told about future videos as well. Hit that button down there to go and check out beginnerdjlessons.com. And why not hit this button below to go and check out another one of my awesome tutorials. See you guys in next week's vid. Ciao.